Good morning dear students, in this video lecture I will be discussing exercise 3c of linear equation. Now the question number 1 says exercise 3c linear equation. I'm changing the subject formula. Now exercise 3c question number 1 subpart A is very easy. It is given if a 4 is subtracted from a number, then the remainder is 1/4 of the number, assuming the number to be n. Now it is already given that the number is n. Question number 1 A is let the number be n. It is already given, so we can write that the number be n. Now according to questions, what they are saying, if 4 is subtracted from the number, that means n minus 4, the remainder is 1/4 of the number. So this is what we have to do. Now how we have to break the sentence? First of all, we have to assume any unknown in this word problem. Word problem, what we have to do? Before this exercise we have seen the word problem in which we were asked to only frame the equation. Here we have to frame the equation as well as we have to solve the equations. Now let the number be x. If 4 is subtracted from the number or from a number, if you remember in lower classes we used to get subtract 4 from 5, like this. So whatever used to come after from, we used to write first, and then the number which used to come before from, we used to write like this. That means crisscross we used to do and put the sign of minus. Here also we will follow same thing. If 4 is subtracted from a number, that number is n, subtracted from a number means 4, and then this will be your equation. Now from form an equation, they are asking you to only form an equation, they are not asking you to solve. So your answer will remain up to here. If they ask you calculate the value of n or find the number, then obviously you have to do the cross multiplication and the solution. Like here, it will become 4n minus 4 is equal to n. So 4n minus 16 is equal to n. So 4n minus n is equal to 16. Here it will become 3n is equal to 16. So n will be equal to 16 by 3. So this much part we are not supposed to solve here. We have to only frame the equation 4 into n. 4n minus 16 is equal to n, then 4n minus n, 16 that side, n by 4. So this much, n will be your decimal. That means 5 whole 1 by 3, or you say 5.3333, or 5.3 bar, okay? Recurring number. Now, question number 1, subpart B only I will be discussing here now, right now. Now, the number, the sum of 3 consecutive even numbers is 42, assuming the greatest number to be x, form an equation. Now what do you understand by consecutive numbers? First you try to understand consecutive numbers, then we will go for consecutive even numbers. Consecutive number. In your lower classes you must have heard of consecutive natural numbers, consecutive odd numbers, consecutive even numbers, right? Now if you understand consecutive numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I write 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 3, 6, 9, 15, sorry, 12, 15, or 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Now, what pattern you will be seeing? Consecutive numbers are those numbers in which certain pattern is observed. Like it is a arithmetic series number. What pattern you will see? Always you have to subtract the second number with the first. So 2 minus 1 is 1, 3 minus 2 is 1, 4 minus 3, 1, 1, 1, 4 minus 2, 2. 2, 2, 2. Now here 6 minus 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Here 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. So what do you see? There is a certain pattern in this case. What pattern is there? That every number is increased by 1 from the previous number. If I take one number x, then the next number will be x plus 1. If I take x plus 1, then I will take x plus 1 plus 1, 2. So this is what? This is a natural number, set of natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 is called natural number. So for natural number, we will take, for framing an equation, we can take x, x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3. Understood? Now in case of even number, if they ask, let the number be x, then your pattern will be like x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 and so on. For multiples of 3, if they ask multiple of 3, so the number will be 3, then x plus 3, x plus 6. Understood? Then again x plus 9 and so on. So these are multiples of 3. If they ask multiple of 4, then your number will be x, x plus 4, x plus 8, x plus 12. Understood? Odd numbers. Again same pattern. Here we are seeing these are odd numbers. So for this, we are having x, x, then we are having x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6. Now, in case of odd numbers and even numbers, if you see odd numbers, this is even number, this is my odd number. Both of them are having same pattern, right? X, x plus 2, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 2. So that means where we are having same pattern, our assumption will also remain same. So this was the method that we discuss about consecutive numbers. Consecutive numbers are those numbers which follow certain patterns when they are written or expanded form. When they are written in expanded form. Now the question was the sum of three consecutive even number is 42. Assuming the greatest number to be x. Now greatest number is x. Question number 2, I think. No, it is 2. No, 1b only. 1b, greatest even number is equal to x. It is given. It is also given. You can write let also here. So greatest number is x. So then a number just before this will be x minus 2. Then a number just before this will be x minus 4. Yes or no? Suppose I say 8. So below the before this we will be having 6. Before this we will be having 4. Before this we will be having 2. And then over. So I am saying 2 numbers are getting decreased. Greatest number is x. So a number just before this will be x minus 2. A number just before x minus 2 will be x minus 4. Now sum of all these three numbers means x, x minus 2 plus x minus 4 is equal to 42. Understood? This is just the reverse case that I have told you. In case of even numbers, what I have told you, the smallest number was x and then I was increasing 2 in each and every number, for each and every number. But here, they have just given opposite, the greatest number they have given, and then they are asking the sum of the three numbers, sum of the three consecutive numbers. So greatest number is this one, then the next greatest number, the next smallest number will be x minus 4. So this is your equation framing. Only this much you have to do. If you want to calculate, though this much is your answer, okay? Now if you want to see or verify, you can see x plus 6, that is equal to 3x minus 2 minus 4, that will be equal to minus 6, 42. So 3x, 42 plus 6, that is 48 divided by 3, 16. Therefore, x is equal to 16, x minus 2 will be equal to 14, x minus 4 will be equal to 12. All these are even numbers. Now, if you add, what answer you are going to get? See, 6 plus 4, 10 plus 2, 12, carry 1, and then 42. So, our answer is correct. So, only this much you have to see in case of framing. If they ask you find the numbers, then we have to simplify this. Now, next question, question number you say B part. Why I am going for B part? Because A part is easy and in B part I have to tell you something that is divisible. Some term is there, one term is there given divisible. So question number 3, okay, 2 I have not solved, no? Let me solve for 2. 2 subpart B I will be calculating here. Now, a man after reading 100 pages, more than one third of a book, finds that 40 more pages than what he has read already is left. That means, assuming the numbers of pages to be x. Now, total, a book contains x number of pages. So, I will write the number of pages be x. If number of pages are x, now they are saying a man after reading 100 pages more than one third. So, number of pages read is equal to number of pages. Number of pages read. Number of pages read is equal to 100 plus one third of x. Why I am writing? because the sentence is a man reads 8800 pages more than one third. More means plus. So number of pages he read is equal to 100 plus 1/3. Now second thing they are saying, then after some times what he finds that one third of a book, he finds that 40 more pages more than what he has already read is left. So what is the left number of pages? Left number of pages is equal to how much? 40 more than whatever he has read. The statement says he has read this many pages. Then second statement says how many are left? 40 more means plus than whatever he has read. Read is 100. 100 plus 1/3x. So these many pages are left. So this left pages plus read pages will be equal to total number of pages. Left number of pages plus read number of pages will be equal to total number of pages. Yes or no? Whatever I have read and whatever is left, if I add both the section, I will get the total number of pages. So here the statement or the framing will become 100 plus x/3 plus 40 plus 100 plus x/3. This whole is equal to x. Now this is the answer. This is the framing of the equation. If you want to calculate, you all can calculate and then get the answers. Now question number 3, I will be going 3 subpart B. 3 subpart A is very easy, you all can solve. It is very simple, it is like class 7th or 8th standard level question. Now question number 3B is also easy, but here as I have to discuss, already I have discussed consecutive numbers, divisible. Now if I say, in the previous chapter we all have discussed factorization, in which I told you about factors. Now I said, what is the factor of 6? Factor of 6, you all will say, sir, 2, 3 and 1. Now what is the meaning of factor actually? The meaning of factor is, whenever this factor will divide the given number, the remainder will be 0. Now here 6 is there, if I divide by 2, remainder will be 0. Remainder is equal to 0. 2 3s are 6 and remainder is equal to 0. This 3 is what? Quotient. If I divide 6 with 3, what will be my remainder? Quotient 2. This is my quotient. Remainder is equal to 0. So this is the meaning of factor. When we say certain number is a factor of that number, that means that particular number will divide that particular number completely, leaving remainder is equal to 0. Now same is the case with divisible. If I say 6 is divisible by 3, that means 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. This is quotient and 0 is my remainder. Understood? If I say certain number is divisible by certain number, that means that particular number is completely divisible and the answer quotient will be a whole number, but the remainder will be a 0. This is the meaning of divisible and factors. Now when I say 5 divided by 2, if 5 is divided by 2, that means my answer will be 2 will be my quotient and 1/2 will be my remainder. Yes or no? If I say 5 is divided by 2, so quotient will be 2, remainder will be 1/2. So here I have, in case of division, remainder may lie or may not get. If I say 6 divided by 2, again remainder will be 0. So when the word divided is used, so there may or may not be, remainder is equal to 0. The remainder may or may not be equal to 0. But in case of divisible and factors, remainder will be 0 always. Here it is not always case. Now based on this, we have 3B question we have to solve. Let me clean the board. So the question says, the sum of 3 consecutive natural numbers divisible by 3 is 45. Now 3 subpart B, sum of 3 consecutive natural numbers. So what all will be my natural numbers which are divisible by 3? So the numbers will be like x, x plus 3 and x plus 6. Why I am writing this? Because all these number will be divisible by 3 because of this 6. 6 is divisible by 3 and this number itself is divisible by 3. 3 is divisible by 3, this number is itself divisible by 3. So entirely this whole number will be divisible by 3, entirely divisible by 3, entirely divisible by 3. So according to question, x plus 3 plus x plus 6 will be equal to, it's better to write in brackets to make it a one number. This is one number, this is another number, this is another number, is equal to 45. Now we have to, I think, calculate the values also here, na? Based on that word equation, find the whole numbers, find the three numbers. So this is my equation. Now we have to find, so x plus 3, 3x plus 9 is equal to 45, 3x is equal to 45 minus 9, that means 36, x by 3, x is equal to 12. So the other number is x plus 3, that means 15, x plus 6, 18. Now if you add all these three numbers, definitely you will get 45. Now question number 3b, after that I am going to solve question number 4a. Now question number 4a is also very easy. They are saying the denominator of a fraction is one more than double the numerator. Okay, if both the numerator and the denominator are increased, well and good, very fine. The fraction becomes this much. Assuming the numerator to be x, obtain an equation. The numerator is given x. Numerator is what? Numerator is equal to x. It is given, right? Now denominator. Denominator is equal to, they are saying the denominator of a fraction is one more than double the numerator. One more than double the numerator. First of all, double, then one is more. So this is my denominator. So what will be my fraction here? F-R-A-C-T. Fraction will be equal to numerator upon denominator. That means x upon 2x plus 1. Correct? This is my fraction and this value only we have to find. Now, second they are saying, if something is done to this, what is done? Let us see. If both the numerator and the denominators are increased by 4, both numerator and denominator are increased. So I can write new numerator is equal to x plus 4, new denominator is equal to what? 2x plus 1 plus 4, yes or no? 2x plus 1 is my original one and then plus 4 because both are increased. Now the new fraction becomes, new fraction will be equal to x plus 4 whole divided by 2x plus 1 plus of 4. Now this is my new fraction. According to my question, what is given here? X plus 4 by 2x plus 1 plus 4 is equal to 3 by 5. Now if we do cross multiplication, we will get the value. Now here 5 will come here, x plus 4 is equal to 3 into 2x plus 5. Now this is 5x plus 20 is equal to 6x plus of 15. Now 5x minus of 6x is equal to 15 minus of 20. Now why I have brought this x? Because in the previous part of this lecture, the previous exercise of this chapter only, I have told always try to bring variables towards left hand side. So 5x minus 6x is equal to minus x. This is equal to minus 5. So x will be equal to 5. So you got x value is equal to 5. My fraction is x upon 2x plus 1. So I will substitute 5. 2 into 5 plus 1. That means 5 upon 11. So this will be our answers. Now I will be moving on to question number 5, subpart, no need of 5 or 5. Okay, let's solve 5 also and then 6 also, one part I will solve, 5 and 6. Let me clean the book. Now question number 5, as I told, let me solve question number 5. Let's go for A or B. Let's take B only. A I have already solved. Now 5b, in a 2-digit number, the ratio of the digits at the unit place to the tens place is 3 is to 2. If the digits are reversed, the resulting number is 27 more than the original number. Assuming the digits at the unit place to be x, obtain an equation, find, also find the two digit number. Now, in our lower classes, you all must have read, you all must have solved the problems based on ratio, in which when the numbers were given in ratio, we used to take common factors, right? We used to write a common factor. So here also we can write, let the common factor to be x. Now the number will be equal to unit place number to tens place, I think it is given. Unit place and tens place. So unit place digit is equal to 3x because of this common factor. Tens place digit will be equal to 2x. No doubt in this. Let the common factor be x, then unit place digit will become 3x, tens place digit will become 2x. So what will be my number? If I will frame the numbers, then original number is equal to, see, if I have a number like 23, we used to write 20 plus 3 or 2 tens plus 3 ones. We used to write, I hope all of you know, 2 tens, this all things were taught in our lower class. So here tens place digit is 2x, so I can write 2x into 10 because of tens position plus 3x into 1. That means 20x plus of 3x, that is 23x. Right. So I was saying original number is equal to 2x into 10 plus 3x into 1. I hope all of you understood how we have framed 23 used to write 2 tens plus 3 ones. 2 tens means 2 into tens because of its position. Position is tens position, right? Now, if the numbers are reversed, so I will write reversed number will be equal to, means tens position digit will go in the ones place and ones place digit will come in the tens place. So this will become like 3x into 10 plus of 2x, which is equal to 32x. Now, according to the question, what they are saying that if the digits are reversed, the resulting number is more than the original number. That means this number becomes greater than the lower number. So I will write 32x minus of 23x is equal to 27. Now this I have simplified, okay? But if you are asked to frame the equations, then you have to write, framing the equation actually you have to write, I have simplified here. So equation will be like 3x, or you say 30x plus 2x minus of 20x plus of 3x is equal to 27. This is my equation, okay? This is my equation framing. As per the book, we have to frame like this. We will not simplify. After that, we will simplify. Is equal to 27. So it is like 9x is equal to 27. X is equal to 3. Division we will do. Now, what are the numbers? Original numbers we have to find, right? We have to find the original numbers only. What is my original number here? Find the two digits. Okay, two digits means first digit is 3x. 3x. Unit place. Unit place digit is equal to 3 into 3, that means 9, and then tens place digit is equal to 2x, that means 2 into 3, that is 6. So these are the digits, original number we have to find. So we will write, here now, original number, where is my original number? This one. So this number means we are having 69. How we are having? You just put the value tens place 6 and ones place 1. So this will become 6, this will become 9. So tens place 6 into 10 plus 9, 69. Or else you here only you put, where you will put, my dear? In this line, in place of x you will put how much? It will become 20 into 3 plus 3 into 3. That means again 69 here. Here you cannot put. This is simplified. Actually, I should not have done this portion only. It is of no use. We should keep here like this only. No need of simplifying. Otherwise, it will create problem for your solution. For you giving the exact numbers, it should be this much only, this, and then finalize this. Now, next question is based on question number. Can I solve that side? Yeah. Okay. 6A. Question number 6A. Question number 6A says that the age of a man is 3 times the age of a son. After 10 years, the age of the man will be double that of son. Assuming the age of the son to be x, obtain the relation and find their present age. Okay. Son's age. Let son's age be x. Though it is given here, we can write, okay. Let the son's age be x. Now, the question says, son's age is this, father's age is 3 times his age. So, I will write, father's age is equal to 3x. After 10 years, the condition says after 10 years, what is going to happen? Son's age will increase by 10, so it will become x plus 10. Father's age also will increase. Yes or no? At present, son is having x years of age, father is having 3 times of his son, right? After 10 years, both of them will become older. Both of their ages will increase by 10. So, I have to write, after 10 years, son's age will become x plus 10, father's age will become 3x plus 10. Now, the question says, according to the question, that the son's age, that means x plus 10, is double the age of father. The father will become twice the age of his son. So, this is my equation. Now, we will solve this. So, we will get 2x plus 20 is equal to 3x plus 10. So 2x minus of 3x is equal to 10 minus of 20. Minus x is equal to minus 10. X is equal to 10. So son's age is 10 years. Father's age is 3x. That means 3 into 10. 30 years. Understood? Now, in the same way, we are having one more question I will be solving for this exercise, and then rest all the other problems you all will solve in your home. I hope you should be able to solve everything. I am making it clear. So, last question from this exercise for today's video lecture. Rest other sum you all will solve at your home. Now, question number 7 says that divide rupees 243 in 3 parts such that half of the first part, 1/3 of the second part, and 1/4 of the third part are all equal. So we have a number is equal to 243. Now we have divided this number into 3 parts. Now let the parts be, we can mention it, let the parts be, let the parts be first for f, second and third. Let the part be fst, first, second, third. Now, according to question, what they are saying, half of first part is equal to 1/3 of second part. This is equal to 1/4 of third part. Understood? Half of the first part is equal to 1/3 of the second part is equal to 1/4 of the third part. Now, there are two methods to solve this. One method that I will teach you, with the help of taking constant k. Let the parts be first, second, third, and constant be k. Okay, when the constant is k, then we will put here k here. is equal to k let. Now, why this is method I am using? This method is based on ratio and proportion. In your higher class, in your class 10, you have one chapter based on this for ratio and proportions, where you have to use k. And if you understand here, I hope that in that class it will be easy for you to make it clear. Now, if I say 1 by half of f is equal to 1 third of s is equal to 1 fourth of t is equal to k, that means I can say 1 by half of f is equal to k, yes or no? So I can write f is equal to 2k. Now, if I say 1 by third of s is equal to also k, because all the 4 are equal, so I will write s is equal to 3 times of k. Then from here I will say 1 by 4 of t is equal to k, so t will be equal to 4 times of k. No doubt in this, half of f is equal to k, because all the 4 are equal, half of 3 is equal to 6. So we got f is equal to 2k, s is equal to 3k, t is equal to 4k. Why we have done? We have got all the values in one constant k. Now, according to question, first plus second plus third will be equal to 243. Yes or no? We can say first term plus second part plus third part is equal to 243. So first part is equal to 2k, second part is equal to 3k, third part is equal to 4k, is equal to 243. 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9k. 9k is equal to 243. So k will be equal to 243 by 9. So 9 2s are 18. 18 means the 6, 7, 7, 27. So k is equal to 27. You got k value 20 seconds. So first part will be equal to 2 into 27, that is 54. Second part is 3 into 27, that is 81. And third part is 4 into 27, means 108. Now, if you add all these, you will get 243. 8 plus 1, 9 plus 4, 13. 1 carry, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 8, 14. 14 means 4 and then 2. So, in this way, we finished this lecture. Second part, it is already given in your textbook. In hint section, you all can read and understand. I hope this is the easy method which I find suitable for you to dictate and teach you here. If you want to go for another method which is given in your textbook, in your hint section, you all can follow that as well. Thank you for listening my video and watching my video.